And I want you guys to think, there's something special about functions that they have that all relations don't have. Just like squares have all four sides the same, right? So that thing is going to show up in our definition. And then we're going to see how we check for it or how we visualize it in our examples, non-examples, and characteristics. Here's the definition. A function is a relation. Here comes the difference. In which every input x has exactly one output y. And I'm going to jump down to the example first before we talk about characteristics. Let's make a quick XY table. And we're going to put those same XY pairs into a mapping diagram. I'm going to start with negative 3. 0, 2, 4. A lot of times when I make mapping diagrams, I do the oval after the number so I make sure it fits. And I'm going to map my XY pairs. So 2 goes with 3, negative 3 goes with 2, 0 with 0, and 4 with 7. Each one of these x's has exactly one y. That's different than what we just mapped over here. Do you see how this 2 had two different y's? This makes it a function, I mean a relation, but not a function. If this x has more than one y, it's not like a square with all the sides the same size. This is the one thing that makes this stay. And over here, because each of these only has one, this is a function and not just a relation. Let's do some non-examples real quick. I'm going to put the same ordered pairs in my XY chart. Oh, thanks, guys. I was almost going off the paper, which is why it was. Look how close I got to the end. If you notice here, this X and this X are the same, but they go to two different Y's. We see that? So if I was mapping this, this 2 is what's going to show us that this is not a function. And it just takes one. It takes one x having two different y's that makes this just a relation and not a function. When I've got just ordered pairs, this is my favorite way to check it, is to move them into a mapping diagram, because just visually for me, seeing that one that has two arrows going off of it shows that it's not one. But we have another way to check when they're graphed. And I think one of you in here wrote me a question about this yesterday. Didn't somebody write, can a circle be a function? I think it was in this class. And a circle cannot be a function because it's not going to pass the test I'm going to talk about next. A major characteristic of a function is what we call the VLT. And that's not a sandwich. Vertical line test. Which direction does a vertical line go? Up and down, right? Horizontal goes across, vertical goes up and down. So we're looking for a line that would be parallel to the y-axis. And here's what we're going to say here. The vertical line test can be used to determine if a graph is a function. The vertical line touches the graphed line, more than once, it is not a function. We will be coming back to this idea tomorrow, and I know we're really close to the end of class, but I want you guys to just draw with me a really quick sketch of a graph. Here's an XY axis. Not all relations make straight lines. So I could have XY pairs that end up making like a sideways U. Visually for me, when I think about the vertical line test, I picture my pencil being parallel to the y-axis. And if I move it along this graphed line, is my pencil touching that line in more than one place? Do you see it? And I'm going to draw it in with my highlighter. I could put it anywhere on the graphed line, but like if I put it right here where it's parallel, it's touching this graphed line here and here. That means it does not pass the vertical line test. So this is a relation, but it's not a function. With that, we're going to get this glued into your notebook on the very next page.